When is accounting book not accounting book? You can check out Octopuses Have Zero Bones for a great reference of that because it's about counting, yeah, but this is smart counting that most middle school kids aren't going to know. It deals with the base numbers, 1 through 10, because we deal with the base 10 blocks, but it presents it in a way that those younger kids in elementary school will be entertained by when you check out the art, but it also combines a lot of facts, a lot of STEM facts, animal facts, and earth facts that those elementary school kids and those middle school kids aren't going to know, and it does so in a format that engages all of them. It really is one of the best counting books we've ever seen, and it kind of eschews to the, I'll call it the mindset of kids are going to be as smart as you allow them to be. Octopuses Have Zero Bones is the counting book that those really clever kids are going to get when they're babies. Well, when they're like, 3 to 5, mom and dad will read it to them and it's going to feed that curiosity. It's going to plant the seeds that say, okay, how many hearts does an octopus have? It's got three. The book is not all about octopuses. That's just the first fact that came to the top of my head. It's loaded with those Nat Geo kids factoids that they love, and it's done in an artistic way that those ages are going to like too. It's not done using photographs like Nat Geo Kids. It's done using art. It's gorgeous. Who's it by? Ann Richardson with illustrations by Andrea Antonotti. And it's just gorgeous. It really is one of the best counting books you're going to see because it's smart. It treats kids, those younger kids, like the smart little vessels they can be by giving them something they can measure up to. It's gorgeous. Check it out. It's a book that's going to be in your forever library. It is Octopuses Have Zero Bones.